Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are doing Valentine's Day theme activities for kids. In today's video, we see three very simple and fun activities we could do for Valentine's Day with our kids. The first activity is matching the hearts. This is a simple matching activity made from recycled cardboard. Heart shapes were cut out from the cardboard and I made various patterns on them, and then the hearts were cut in half. Valentine's Day provides a great opportunity to teach our kids the importance of love. Though Valentine is often associated with romantic love, but we can teach our kids how love is not just romantic and we should love and care for everyone. My daughter always enjoys activities like this. There are so many learning opportunities in this activity, like matching and sorting skills, comparison skills, and fine motor skills. Sometimes we put out activities that we know are really easy for our kids, a skill that they have mastered long ago. It is to promote independent work skills, to help boost their confidence, to work on secondary skills like fine motor, hand-eye coordination and one-on-one correspondence, to give them a moment to calm down and refocus on other activities. This is a cute activity nonetheless and easy to adapt for different skill levels, such as less and more, higher or lower numbers, puzzle pieces, etc. The next super fun activity is Heart Hunt Secret Message. For this activity, write a message on a handful of index cards. One word per card. Then draw hearts on the opposite side. The first word in the message gets one heart. The second word gets two hearts. And the third word gets three hearts, and so on. Hide the cards throughout your house. Have your kids hunt for the cards and then sort them from the lowest number of hearts to the greatest to decode the message. This is a fun activity that we did with our kids to get them excited for Valentine's Day. My kids love hunting for things first thing in the morning, and this game adds a little math and a secret message into the mix. We've been all about the simple setups lately. This one was as simple as they come, and my son was so engaged and enjoyed it thoroughly. It's easy to overthink learning and play. It's easy to think we should be doing more. It's easy to think that things need to be new, big, and flashy. Play can be simple, it can be inexpensive, it can be manageable in our house. Simple setups are still so full of fun and opportunities to learn, practice, and reinforce skills. My son actually requested I hide the cards again for a second round, even after he had decoded the message. The next activity is pom-pom painting. For this activity, all you need is some pom-poms, clothespin, paint, and a cardboard. We use cardboard, but for this you can also use canvas or a thick craft paper. And instead of pom-poms, you can also use cotton balls, Q-tips or even tiny fingers. We love making pieces of art we can display in our house, and this pom-pom painting is just perfect for that. With this activity, they will get lots of practice to tune in those fine motor skills. It also provides great opportunity to review shapes and colors. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel. Have a great day. Stay safe and keep smiling.